What's up, everyone? Welcome to this POV review by AutoTop.nl. My name is Max, and we're here today with this very cool Audi RS3 sedan. Really, really cool. I think this is my favorite type of RS3 ever made, because this shape, this body type, it just suits the RS3 so much better than that hatchback. And it's starting to rain really bad. So I'm going to get in and I'll do a more comprehensive walk around later on. So we'll start with driving and sound, because let me just open this for some extra sound, because this thing sounds good. It sounds really good. I was actually quite surprised, because it's quite loud. Okay, let's go for dynamic, obviously. This in sport, and we're ready to go. Oh my god, because we have that sunroof open, you get that really cool five-cylinder sound with those bangs on the upshift, crackles on the overrun. I mean, that's just awesome. Woo. So this is real quattro weather. So real quattro weather with a real quattro, because this car feels incredible. We've done a review on the hatchback version of the RS3 already, and I said it then too, because this has that new engine, or maybe it wasn't the TTRS, because this has the new 2.5-liter 5-cylinder with that aluminium block instead of the cast iron engine block. You have a much lighter nose. They have recalibrated the quattro system to be a bit more rear biased, and that together just makes it a much more complete car, a much more drivable car as well, because the old RS3 was just the king of understeer. Now though, it feels much more agile, it feels much more controllable. Is it as good as a BMW M2 chassis? No, of course not. It's more that you buy the engine with this car. So you want that five-cylinder, you buy that engine, and you accept that the rest comes with that engine. But in this weather, I'm not complaining, because this is way quicker around here with this rain than a BMW M2 would be. So we have 400 horsepower and 480 newton meters of torque, 0 to 100 kilometers an hour, 4.1 seconds, top speed 250 with optional 270, I believe. So let's do a launch control in the wet. So sport, this one in sport, foot on the brake, full throttle. Wow, that's a lot of traction. Holy moly, I didn't really expect that to be so drama-less. That was quick. Wow. So that's the biggest benefit of this car. I mean, I couldn't have picked a better day than today to show you one of the reasons to buy this car, because you can use this any day, anywhere, any weather, anytime. And I think that's one of the cool things about quattro, about Audi, and about the fact that they just won't leave that that mindset. They just won't change that. They will always keep their performance cars with four-wheel drive. And because they are now developing their chassis, their suspension, the Quattro system, and making the cars more about driving fun and about having a great balance and just great chassis control, I think that they can go a long way. I think that these cars will keep getting better and better. I mean, this is just full throttle through a corner with it. It's just soaking wet. That's impressive. And it feels really safe. It gives you confidence to drive a bit quicker. Yeah, so all in all, great car. But I still have to show you the outside. So I think the rain is a bit better now. This is so much traction. Oh my God, I'm seriously, honestly surprised by how little understeer this car has. Okay, so I'll show you guys the outside really quick. So, this blue is really cool. Aura blue is the color, and you know, especially with all those sort of matte aluminium trim pieces in the front bumper, the mirrors around the windows, and at the back, the diffuser with the performance exhaust, so black tips. I don't really like these wheels, but you can get other ones, of course, with a black grille. I mean, I think this car looks really good. I think you really, really must have the sedan, not the hatchback. I think the sedan looks really cool. It's sort of a premium sedan, a little one. It's very muscular and yeah, very impressive to look at. And also something cool is that when we look at the tire sizes, we have a 235 section in the rear and we have a 255 section at the front. Again, to balance out that understeer, to give the front a bit more grip and to shift that balance to the rear so that the rear wheels will lose traction a bit earlier than the front wheels. So more power will go to the back, essentially neutralizing the understeer a bit. So we borrowed this car at JC Baarse in Aalsmeer in the Netherlands. So big thanks to those guys, always really nice. And if you are interested in this car, if you live in the Netherlands or Germany or Belgium or whatever, and you want this car, then check out their website. Because I really love this spec. It reminds me of the old RS4 that featured on Top Gear with that golden M3 and the red C63, if I'm remembering correctly. But just that older RS4 with that V8, you also had this type of color. So yeah, really cool. So thanks for watching, guys. I'm going to end it here because it's really shit weather, and I hope you enjoyed this one. You can subscribe by clicking on the little icon in the bottom right corner, and you can follow us on social media, just search for AutoTopNL. Alrighty, thanks guys, see you at the next one. Bye.